Hello friends, in this video I'm going to do some examples from level 2 maths 2008 paper on algebra. Okay, now most of the questions, I think so I would try to finish in 10 minutes, 5 questions. Okay, so speed is not focus, but I want to do as much as possible. Expand and simplify. So I've got three brackets, you want to expand and simplify. So what you can do in different ways. So I like to expand, expanding these two brackets first. So I'll write this as it is. That is, you've got 3x plus 1. So if you expand this, you can use the FOIL method, the first. So x times x gives me x squared. Then you got x times 2, which is 2x. Then you got minus 1 times x, which is minus x, and minus 1 times 2, which is minus 2, just like that. So this is 3x plus 1. I have to simplify this first before expanding further. So this is x squared plus x minus 2. Okay. Now you'd expand again 3x with all the three terms and with 1 with. So not going to put the arrows now. So 3x times x is 3x cubed. 3x times plus x is 3x squared. And 3x times minus 2 is minus 6x. Now I'm expanding with plus 1. So plus 1 times x squared is plus x squared. Or you can write 1x squared if you want to. 1 times x is plus 1x. And 1 times minus 2 is minus 2. So you can see I have written this in an order so that you can group the like terms. So 3x cubed will remain 3x cubed. This will remain, this will become 3x squared plus 1x squared is 4x squared. And this is minus 5x minus 2. And this is your answer. Okay. Now, if in level 2 you're allowed a graphic calculator, I'll show you how to check this on a graphic calculator. It's a bit cunning, but it's always good to check your answer. So what you can do is go to graph, okay, or you can also go to table. Okay, so let us go to table and type in this equation. So you go bracket 3x plus 1. Then you got x minus 1 times x plus 2. Okay. And then this is your question and this is your answer. So in y2, you type in 3x to the power 3 plus 4x squared. Why I'm showing you this method is it's always good to check your answer and be confirm that you got it right, because it's an achieved question. And you should get it. And then you go to set. You can take any number, say 1 to 5 is fine. Okay. And then you go execute and then go to table. So you've got two tables. So this is for the first equation and this is for the second equation. So this is y1 and this is y2. And if they are same, you can be pretty sure that your answer is right. So you can give yourself a smiley face. Okay. Moving on to the next question. 6x to the power 5 over square root of 9x to the power 16. So this is equal to 6m to the power 5 over, can I write this as 3 squared times m to the power 16 to the power half. Now square root, you should know this, square root of x is same as x to the power half. Okay, so what I've done is I've removed the square root and put the index or the exponent of half. Now here you have to apply the power of power rule. So you have to, so this will become, I write this as 3 times 2m to the power 5 over, so here you have to multiply this power with this power. So this is multiplication of power. So this is 3 times 3 to the power 2 times half, and m to the power 16 times half. So it's distributing this half to both these powers. And this is where most of you can go wrong, that you only times this by half, but you don't times this 2 by half. So this is 3 times 2m to the power 5 over 3 times m to the power 8. Okay, so now, so 3 and 3 will get cancelled, so you've got 2. M to the power, I can write as 5 minus 8 when you're dividing exponents, or when you're simplifying powers, you take away the exponent. So this is 2m to the power minus 3. This is fine, but if you don't like the negative power, that is same as 2 times 1 over m cube. So the final answer is 2 over m cube. Okay, so this is your final answer. Okay, now next question. You have to simplify this. So here you have to factorize this. Okay, so this is, I'm not going to expand the numerator, x plus 2 times x plus 3 over x the whole squared minus 3 squared. And now this is the difference of two squares. You should know this formula. It's a very useful formula. A squared minus b squared is a minus b times a plus b. It's a very powerful and useful formula for students of algebra. So this is x plus 2 times x plus 3 over, if you don't understand the formula, expand this, you'll get this. So this, using this formula, I can write x minus 3 times x plus 3. So let me use a different color, so this and this gets cancelled. So your final answer is x plus 2 over x minus 3. Okay. You can again check this on the calculator like this. I think you'd go to table, delete this. And okay, this is a cunning way. So this can be written as x plus 2 times, as you see in the example, you can type in like that, and this is divided by x squared minus 9. Okay, this is one. This is a question, and what's your answer? Execute. And the answer, we are seeing that is same as x plus 2 divided by x plus 3. This is a neat way of checking your answers, okay? And then you already have set your table from 1 to 5, so table. So you can see here, this is, at this point, yeah, at 3, your function is not defined because this becomes 0, and that's why you have an error here. Okay, so you have x minus 3 is an error here. Okay, I'm not sure what's happened. Oh, I've done a mistake here. Sorry, yeah, so this should be x minus 3. Okay, yeah, always good to check like this. Okay, let me delete it. Okay, so let me see. So this is an error. This is to, when x is 3, this will become 0, and the function is, this is not defined at 3. And here you can see, you got the same answers. Okay, next question. Okay, solve this. So, solving it, this is an inequality. So, we'll treat this as an equality. So, basically, you will be grouping the x's on one side. So, let us expand this. So, this is 6x minus 2 is greater than 1 minus 2x. Now, when you're dealing with inequality, this is called an inequality. This is greater than, or if you read from here, it's less than. You treat it as an equality, but the inequality will change only when you're dividing or multiplying by a negative number. So I want to group the x's on one side and the numbers on the right-hand side. So what I'm going to do, I don't want minus 2x sitting here, so I'm, I want to cancel that. So I'll write plus 2x here. Now if you write plus 2x here, you have to write plus 2x here. Okay? Let me use a different color. And I don't want this plus 2 here, so I'm going to add 2 to this side. it add 2 to this side. Yes, you do same thing as you're doing in equation, okay, or it's balancing of equation. So let me bring the blue color. So this and this gets cancelled, and this gets cancelled. So you've got 7, sorry, this is 6x plus 2x is 8x is greater than 3, just like that. And if you divide this side by 3, you divide this side by, sorry, 8. So this implies x is greater than 3/8, just like that. Okay, so this is pretty easy, and I will finish with this question. Solve for x, log of x to the base 2 is equal to 3. Now see, this is same as, we are asking the question, 2 to which 2, so whenever you have, suppose log of, let me explain, log of 1000 to the base 10 is 3. Why? Because 10 cube is equal to 1000. So I'll show you this on a calculator. Suppose you go to menus. If you type in log of 1000 is 3, because here the base of log is 10. Okay, so the base of, so the question is 10 to which power gives you 1000. Okay, suppose someone is asking what is log of 8 to the base 2. They're asking you 2 to which power gives you 8. So the answer is 3. So here we are asking the same question, 2 to 3 is equal to 8. This and this are equivalent statements. So you can understand x is equal to 8. So basically this is same as log of 8 to the base 2 is equal to 3. So here we are asking the question, 2 to which power gives me 8? That's 3. See you in the next week.